My goodness, if you guys can see the mess that I have. It's a good mess. It's a beautiful mess to me. I want to show you guys what I've been up to. Oh yeah, that's what I said I was going to do it, and now I'm going to do it. So how are you guys doing? I'm doing fine. Today is, what is today, Saturday? I'm still up from Halloween. Yeah, still up from Halloween. Anyways, the napkin, tissue paper, is that what it's called? Napkin paper. I showed you guys in the previous video how to make your own washi tape or tissue tape with double-sided adhesive tape. I ended up marking them up, and let me show you guys. Let's see, what can I use underneath? It's kind of distracting right here. But anything that I pull is going to be distracting. Okay. So I inked them up, and they came out really nice. Really loved the way they came out. So all of these are that big napkin you guys see me put together. Just now, like I said, I inked up the edges. Maybe I could show you two at a time, so I won't take your guys' time. And I have some more. Different pattern, I think, on the other side. Let me look. Okay. And all together, they look yummy. You see that? Okay, that's that share. I already showed you guys how to do it. Here's the other one. I finished it off. It goes this way. So it already has a double-sided tape on it, and now all I want to do is, see, take it apart. Now how cute is that? And then if I wanted to add some something to it, I'll use the Ranger Distress ink and Firebrick. Did I choose the color? No, I don't. I usually don't. I just grab what's there. I like everything that I have, so it wouldn't disappoint me. Now, how pretty is that? Every single piece. In love with this new thing. And then I'll probably mark those up. I will definitely mark those up. And then here is another napkin with spider webs on it. Here's the bigger ones. And then I had a little extra, so I used one of the thinner tapes. I'll use these all year long, and I'll ink up the edges. Let's see what one of them would look like inked up. How about we use this Distress Ink Tea Dye color. I don't have those sponge thingies that everybody uses, so this is good enough. I'm just happy to even have these inks because of Lori. Lori B, I'm still very grateful for these inks. Thank you so very much. I've been having a blast. You can see I have ink from yesterday on my hands still. And I love it. Okay, that's what that looks like. Isn't that pretty? I couldn't even like just tap into it. Love that. Look it. And then I had a coffee filter laying around in my kitchen, and I was like, let me mess with that. Here's my coffee filter I messed with these beautiful inks. I really love the way that came out. And it's not just stamping on top. It's actually something that I taught myself. And I'll show you guys on the next video. Because I really like that. And that's going to go in front of a journal. And then I have pattern tissue paper. Pattern paper to make, I don't know, maybe a dress. And I've been messing and just inking away all of these pretty marks. Isn't that gorgeous? My favorite is these daisies. I think that's what they are. And these are gorgeous too. I actually have a hard time choosing what's my favorite. But I'll run it through so you guys can see. I ran out of stamps. Different stamps. I think I about used all the stamps I have. Love the butterflies also. The little mushrooms. I love them all. So for instance, here's a piece. And I can ink that up if I wanted to. I think it's super cute. I want to see how translucent it is. How about you guys? Let's see how translucent this is. Pretty translucent. There's the back. There's the front. Let's put it down on something. Let's find something. How about just what's underneath here? Oh yeah, I can see the color come right through. Love that. So that's what I have, and I still have some extra space up here if I wanted to work on. And I don't know what's easier, to store them this way or take them apart and store them. I haven't figured that out yet because I haven't cleaned up my desk. It's been Halloween. And we've been getting ready for Halloween for a few months now. And always still the last day before Halloween, we still had a lot to do. as far as costumes, because my kids' costumes are handmade and we have to put a lot of thought into them because we usually try to repurpose everything. Yeah, so that's what I have to share with you guys, and see you guys soon. I still have not done Victor's challenge. Sorry, Victor. It's been Halloween and I've been very busy, but it's still next to me, and I just might do this tomorrow. I'm not opening the shop. It's the day after Halloween, and what I need to do at the shop actually is put away all the Halloween costumes. I did not even sell one. Sucks, but it is what it is. So I need to put all that away and put them into the garage to be able to bring them out again next year. Hopefully we still have the shop next year. What else I'm doing? Oh, and tomorrow's Saturday, really in reality tonight because it's after midnight. What else? Bobby's going to work. He's going to work some overtime. You definitely need that overtime. I think he would work overtime every weekend if they gave it to him right now. So I'll be home with the kids. Definitely enjoying the kids. So I think I'll find time to do your challenge, Victor. And I've got a spin to it. It's going to be different, okay? It's going to be the same but different. And I like seeing you open your Happy Mail today that Gina Aaron sent you. I like seeing you open Happy Mail. I like seeing you happy. Okay, so talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye, everybody.